Okay. The presentation was on suicide, and I'm reading it to Dr. Guyan. United Nations Suicide Prevention Day, which is going to be September 30th, which is Sunday, and he's doing it from a socio-economic perspective. Dr. Rudy Guyan, and he did it September 2017. The United Nations has set aside, September 10th, September 10th, which is Sunday, as a day to focus annually on suicide prevention. The act of suicide is about the individual being responsible for his or her own death. The concerns of the UN seems to be that the preservation of life is a priority. However, the policies of some institutions and individuals who set the agenda for the future of humankind seem to consider suicide as a most welcomed behavior. Please have to listen to this carefully. In the final analysis, suicide reduces population. Concerns about suicide prevention are concerns for saving lives. United Nations acknowledging of a day when all thoughts should be on the preservation of life through suicide prevention awareness may not be in keeping with those individuals and institutions that are placing upon themselves the right to determine who lives and who dies. On July 1980, for example, the Jimmy Carter White House releases the findings of its Global 2000 Commission. The commission called to reduce world population by 2 billion people by the turn of the century is endorsed by Secretary of State Edmund Muskie. Is the United Nations Suicide Prevention Awareness diametrically opposed to the objectives of the Global 2000 Report Commission? The main mindset of suicide contemplation is insecurity through feelings of rejection and loss of control, which is insecurity. It is not surprising then that even as the UN tries to promote suicide prevention awareness, the incidence of suicide seems to be increasing in especially countries classed as underdeveloped, which Dr. Guyan calls undermined economies. What confidence a citizen of an undermined economy could have in self, community, or country after reading the following words of General Maxwell Taylor, the former commander-in-chief of the U.S. forces during the Vietnam War, and the chairman of the Joint Chief of Staff under President John Kennedy. This is what he had to say. I have written off more than 1 billion people. These people are in places in Africa, Asia, Latin America. We can't save them. The population crisis and food supply pressure dictate that we should not even try. It's a waste of time. The people will suffer from continuous cycles of a natural disaster, famine, hunger, and drought. Some old fools and young ones may talk of trying to mount a noble effort to help these people. But they can't escape. Unlike General Maxwell Taylor, the UN is saying to old fools and young ones that trying to mount a noble effort to help to prevent the death of someone is indeed appreciated. Suicide prevention speaks to the rising tendencies of death among especially young persons who are considered as high achievers. There was an incident In Guyana, there is one of the highest incidents of suicide, especially among young persons. In this planet, too many high school students consider suicide as an option. However, examination times are not the only periods of high tension for young persons. There are two periods of unnecessary rejection that young people face. An education program is participated in mainly because of a promise that on meeting all the requirements of completing high school, a place will be available for transition to higher studies relating to career choices. When all requirements have been successfully completed in respect to career eligibility, the expectations are that the welcoming door to the career or higher studies would be open. In Guyana, for example, a student having 6 grade 1s, 3 grade 2s, and 1 grade 3, that is 10 subjects that receive XE examination, is denied an opportunity to enter the Caribbean Advanced Proficiency Examination K program to continue her choice of career choice because that student's list of subjects passed did not include a foreign language. Even for students who have successfully graduated from the highest level of the education system, the opportunities for employment by others or by self are a struggle. Is this denial of opportunity for self-development contrived? After reading the following quotation, one is left with no other answer but a resounding yes. Now listen to why Doc is saying this. 1972, the Club of the Rome releases Limits to Growth. The report calls for an end to industrial development efforts in the third world.
Please repeat that, sister.
Oh, Doc asked you where to read it. It's very important. 1972. The Club of Rome releases Limits to Growth. The report calls for an end to industrial development efforts in the third world and outlines a future plagued by scarce resources, especially petroleum and other fossil fuels. It calls for zero growth-oriented economic policy for the advanced sector and a very limited growth policy for the developing sector, asserting that all advancement in the third world must be paid for by deprivation and cutbacks in the advanced sector. Eugenics by any other name is still eugenics. Is there anyone who is still searching for at least one reason why the incident suicide is so high among young people? The United Nations Suicide Prevention Day is a reminder that we live in a world where one for all and all for one must not only be voiced, but it must be an actuality, or we, especially of the undermined economies, will perish. We have no other option but to make Suicide Prevention Day a 365 days of the year phenomenon. We, the following organizations and institutions, support the effort of the executive and members of the United Nations Association Guyana to make the people of Guyana aware of their role in suicide prevention. And we quoted Guyana Day, 1863, Guyana Reparations Committee, and the Forum of the Yes, sorry, 1823, and the Forum of the Temples of Thematic Spirituality. Actually, now you can ask Dr. Guyana, it's quite a mouthful, but I hope you understood the gist of what the student said here, because I don't think we have paid enough attention to the programs that have been set out for us. The global report to Chelsea alive and well, brother and brother Moses have brought it to your attention, colonization plan of 1929, and if you pay attention, you will see the dilemma that we're in. It is no surprise that Exxon is pushing to our country that it is not economically viable to have an oil refinery. It is in keeping with this. They are not going to give you any development in your country, in the quote-unquote third world countries. So it is not by accident. So when I stand and I said on the TV, if we can have certain things that like our oil stay in the ground, I meant exactly that. They are not in your interest. All they are to do is take from you. Global reports said exactly how they're going to do it. Civil unrest. Diseases. They have outlined it all. They're going to do it by famine and all the different things. They're not going to give you any means of development. And if they do give you something, they are taking away from you the majority. You are never going to be able to, because the focus is on your, me, all of us being off planet Earth. And Doc didn't put it in here, but you will be amazed that the Duke of Edinburgh, Prince Philip, taking, I had a quiz and I couldn't figure out who was saying it. Doc asked me several times when I was going Carter, Miskinski, all the people in the club of Rome. He said, no. He's stated that if he were reincarnated, he will come as a deadly virus because of population control. I leave it with you.